In our last video, we are discussing about test and measurement in sports, in which we have discussed about motor fitness test, that is Khelo India fitness test, which is used to measure the physical fitness of our school going children. Next is Barrow fitness test. Barrow fitness test, this test is used to measure the general motor fitness of an individual. In this test, there are three test items: standing broad jump, zigzag run, and medicine ball throw. First, standing broad jump. Standing broad jump. Zigzag run, standing broad jump test, zigzag run test, and last, medicine ball throw test. These are the three test items which is used in Barrow fitness test to measure the general motor ability of an individual. Standing broad jump is used the purpose for writing. You have to write purpose. Sabse first is test items, purpose and procedure. Equipment required, procedure and scoring and evaluation. These five things you have to write. So, standing broad jump. First test items, standing broad jump. The purpose of standing broad jump is used to measure the explosive strength of the leg. Explosive strength means ability of a person to overcome resistance with maximum speed. So, standing broad jump, this test is used to measure the explosive strength of leg muscles. In this, equipment required, we require measuring tape, floor, non-slippy floor for jumping, recording seat, etc. Procedures: first, the person do the warming up. After doing warming up, he will stand behind the starting line, and on the command of go, the persons will jump forward as much as possible. Then he has to jump forward as much as possible. And scoring, he will get 3 times and the best time and the best distance, maximum distance he has jumped is recorded for evaluations. Okay. Standing broad jump, he get 3 tries, and the best distance he has covered is recorded for evaluations. And for evaluations, the distance covered is compared, or the teachers make his own norms for evaluation. This is standing. Next is zigzag run. Zigzag run, this test, the purpose of this test is used to measure the speed, coordinate speed and coordinative ability of an individual. Equipment required, we require measuring tape, cone, stopwatch, recording seat, etc. Procedures, how we will perform. We make a track, we keep 5 cone, 16 feet, 16 feet, and this is 10. Okay, 16 feet and 10 feet. Now, this is a starting point. Start and finish. Finish point. This is a starting and finish point. And on the command of go, the person has to run here and then come here and then he has to go and then down and here and then come. And then he has to come here. The person. Okay, these are the three cone. And you have 5 cone. He has to run here and then here. Then up. Then here. Here and then come down. Now, procedures. How they perform zigzag run. For zigzag run, first the person do warming up. And then after doing warming up, he will come in the starting point. And then he will run in this point, in this procedure. From here, he will run. He will run here and then come down. Feet then here and here, say, and then here. The person has to run 3 laps. Okay. He has to run 3 laps. And the recorded time. The time is recorded. How much time he in how much time he has complete this test, the time is recorded. And for scoring, the time taken to complete the test is recorded. And for evaluation, the time taken to complete the test is compared with some standard norms or the teachers make his own norms for evaluation. This is about the zigzag run. Okay, he has to run 3 times. Okay, first and then again and then again. He has to do 3 laps. Next is medicine ball throw. In medicine ball throw, the person stand and he will medicine ball. Okay, this is a ball and then the test item, that is medicine ball. The purpose of medicine ball is used to measure the upper body strength. And equipment required, we require medicine ball. For girls, we require 1 kg medicine balls. And for boys, we require 3 kg. Okay, for girls, 1 kg. And for boys, 3 kg. And procedure, first the person do the warming up. After doing warming up, he will come in the starting line. And then the person has to throw the ball as much as possible. He has to throw the ball forward. And the distance is measured for scoring. The distance, the cover is recorded. And evaluation, the maximum distance covered is compared or the teachers make his own norms for evaluation. These are the 3 test items which we use in Barrow fitness test to measure the general motor ability of an individual. Next is Howard step test. Howard step test, it is introduced by Bruha in 1943. This Howard step test, it is important. Howard step test. Howard step test. This test, it is introduced by Bruha in 1943. Purpose. The purpose of this test is used to measure the cardiovascular fitness. Cardio is used to measure the cardiovascular fitness. Cardiovascular fitness of an individual. Okay, the purpose of Howard step test is used to measure the cardiovascular fitness of an individual. In Howard step test, equipment required. We require gym bench or box for female gym bench. We require 45 centimeters or 17 inch high, and for male we require 50 centimeters or 20 inch high. Okay, gym bench, we require gym bench, stopwatch and assistant helper, etc. Procedure. Howard step test. The purpose is to measure the cardiovascular fitness of an individual. Equipment, we require gym bench. For female, we require 45 centimeter high or 17 inch high. And for male, we require 50 centimeter high or 20 inch high. Stopwatch and helpers. Procedure. First, the person do the warming up. After doing warming up, he has to come near the gym bench. This is gym bench and this is a person. Now he has to up. Then the person come near the gym bench and then he has to up and down. Okay, the person has to up and down on the gym bench continuously for 5 minutes or until exercise at the rate of 30 steps per minute. Okay, how we perform? First, the persons do warming up. After doing warming up, he come near the gym bench and on the command of go, he will step up and step down on the gym bench for 5 minutes or until exercise at the rate of 30 step. At the rate of 30 step per minute. He has to do 30 step per minute. And after completing, the pulse rate is measured. The assistant measure the pulse rate as pulse 1 for 1 minute or 30 seconds after 1 minute recovery, and again the assistants measure the pulse rate as pulse 2 for 1 minute or 30 seconds after 2 minute recovery, and again the assistants measure the pulse rate as pulse 3 for 1 minute or 30 seconds after 3 minute recovery. And then for computation, for calculating the fitness index, we sum up this pulse 1 plus pulse 2 plus pulse 3 with the help of this this pulse. We can find the fitness index of a person, and there are two methods for calculation of fitness index of an individual. Fitness index. There are two methods. Short form V, duration of exercise, duration of exercise which is taken in second into 100 upon 5.5 into pulse count between 1 to 1.5. Pulse count between 1 to 1.5 minute after exercise. This is a short form to find the fitness index. To find the fitness index of a person. And long form is duration of exercise 100 into duration of exercise upon 2 into sum of pulse 1 plus 2 plus pulse 3. Okay, sum of pulse 1, pulse 2 and pulse 3. Pulse 1, pulse 2 and pulse 3. This is the methods. This is a short form to calculate fitness index of a person and this is a long form. So, this is the procedures how we conduct Harvard step test. The purpose of Harvard step test is used to measure the cardiovascular fitness of an individual. In this, we require gym bench, stopwatch and one assistant or helpers. Procedures. In this test, the person has to step up and step down on the gym bench. Step up and step down on the gym bench for 5 minutes or until exercise at a rate of 30 steps per minute. So, first the person do warming up. After doing warming up, he will come near the gym bench. And on the command of go, he will step up and step down on the gym bench for 5 minutes or until exercise at the rate of 30 steps per minute. And after completing the test, the assistant measure the pulse rate as pulse 1. After pulse 1 for 1 minute or 30 seconds, after 1 minute recovery, and again, the assistant measure the pulse rate as pulse 2 for 1 minute or 30 seconds after 2 minute recovery. And again, the assistant measure the pulse rate as pulse 3 for 1 minute or 30 seconds after 3 minute recovery. And then we calculate the fitness index of a person by using these two formula. Short form, duration of exercise into 100, 5.5 into and this is a long form. For examples, let pulse rate. Pulse rate of a person is 90, 65 and 45. And the duration of exercise is 5 minutes. Then you have to find the fitness index of a person by using long form. Then how you will find? Then yes, we have to take the in second. Therefore, we convert 5 minutes in second. So 5 minutes in second we convert, that is 300 now 100 into 300 upon 2 into sum of pulse 1 plus pulse 2 plus pulse 3 90 plus 65 plus 45 okay that is 75 this is the fitness index of a person this is the procedure to find out the fitness index of a person Next is Rockport walking test. Rockport walking test. This test is also used to measure purpose. This test is also used to measure the cardiovascular fitness. The purpose of Rockport walking test is used to measure the cardiovascular fitness of an individual. In this, we require equipment. We require track across 200 meters or 400 meters running track, stopwatch, one assistant, stopwatch, etc. Procedure. How we will perform first. We will record the weight of a person. Record the weight. First step, record the weight. Record weight in pound. The first step is we have to record the weight of a person. We have to record the weight of a person in pound. And then after that, the person has to walk 1 mile. That is 1609 meters. After that, the assistants measure the pulse rate. Measure pulse rate. Okay. First, the persons we record the weight. We record his weight in pound. After that, the person has to walk or run 1 mile, that is 1609 meters as fast as possible. After that, record the time taken to complete the test. Record the time taken to complete the test, and then measure the pulse rate of a person. That is his heartbeats per minute. And after that, we find his cardiovascular ability. That is VO2 max. By using this formula, that is 132.853 minus 0.69 into weight minus 0.3877 into age of a person age plus okay plus 6.315 into gender and then minus 3.2649 into time how much time he has taken minus 6.315 0.1565 into heart rate. Heart rate. Okay, student, this is the formula to find calculate the VO2 max of a person. And in this weight, we take in weight we take in pound, weight we take in pound, age, this age, gender, for gender, if male, for male we will give 1 and for female, if the female then we will give 0. If it is male, here will be the 1, if she is female then we will write 0. Itna and the time taken to complete the test, itna and heart rate, his heart rate after completing the test. And this is the methods to find out the to find out the cardiovascular fitness of a person using Rockport walking test. And evaluation, for the evaluations we compare the fitness, we compare and analyze with his previous one. And also the student whose VO2 max is maximum, he is considered as fit and healthy. Okay, the student with higher score is considered as more fit and healthy as compared to those who has less score. This is about the Rockport walking test. Next and the last, Rickley and John test. Rickley and John test. This test is used to measure the fitness of our senior citizens. And this Rickley and John test, it is introduced by Robert R. Rickley and Dr. J.C. James. Okay, as for finding out the fitness of a student, we use motor fitness test. In the same manner, to find the fitness of a senior citizens, we use Rickley and John test. And in Rickley and John test, there are 6 test items. And with the help of these 6 test items, we can find the fitness of a senior citizens. That is, 6 test items, that is chair stand test, arms curls up test, sit and reach test, and back stretch test, 8 feet up and go test, and then 6 minute run walk test. These are the 6 test items through which we measure his fitness of a senior citizen. So this we will discuss in our next video. We have complete our test measurement and evaluations in which test it is an instrument. It is an instrument or tools. Okay, test, it is an instrument or tools which we use to obtain data on specific trait or characteristic. For example, weighing machine, flexometers, measuring tape, etc. These are the tests which we use to obtain data. And measurement, it is the reading which we get from the test. And evaluation, it is a subjective judgment based on analysis and interpretation of data. And these three are interrelated with each other. Without test, measurement is not possible. And without test and measurement, evaluation is not possible. And Test and measurement, it is helpful in sports to find out the motor fitness, physical fitness of a student.